What's up, everybody? This is your girl, Pisces Empress 555, coming at you with another love reading for the sign of Scorpio. Scorpio, we're going to take a look at your energy right now, see if we can get some clarity, provide some guidance. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Without further ado, let's get started. Love messages for the sign of Scorpio. Love messages for Scorpio. Okay, Scorpio, your overall energy is the Temperance in reverse. So Scorpio, you're coming out of a place of feeling like you couldn't keep yourself stable, feeling like you couldn't keep yourself calm. Something was very unsettling to you. Something was very unfair to you. It may have caused you to respond and react in a way that you never have before. So it was something that was very disturbing, unstable. So you're coming out of that energy, and so now we're in more of a carefree mode. We have the Fool card in the upright, more of a carefree mode, just taking the time to overlook, just review some things that went on. You're just seeing things for what they are and not for what you want them to be. It's just a different point now. Just feeling more aware of what was going on at that time. Recognizing and seeing your mistakes, recognizing and seeing the mistakes of the person that you were with. So yeah, Scorpio, that's where you are currently at this time. And then we have the Three of Swords in the upright. So yeah, you're coming out of a place, a relationship that may have had a third party situation. This doesn't have to be deception. It could be, but it could be anything that came between you and the other person that interfered with the relationship. It caused some kind of strife. It's caused some kind of struggle. You could have dealt with an Aquarius, Libra, or Gemini. It was just very heart-wrenching. It just pulled on your heartstrings so much. It caused you so much stress that you were just over feeling that way, because you were fighting hard, Scorpio, to just be you, to be strong in the situation and just provide the best that you could for this person. But maybe they didn't appreciate it. And that happens, you know, that happens a lot in relationships, okay? So we have the Lover's card in the reverse. So yeah, this was definitely a love situation that you came out of, Scorpio. It was something that meant a lot to you. At one time gave you a lot of fulfillment, but you're no longer in this situation anymore. And it could have been because of this Three of Swords energy, third party. So it's something that now that you're reflecting and seeing that even though it temporarily gave you fulfillment for however long you were with the person, but you always felt like, you could have felt like you deserved better. You know, I'm hearing ram in the bush, third party energy, ram in the bush. Maybe something came up that acted like a ram in the bush, or something threw you off course that was just surprising, like a ram in the bush. I'm seeing 444 on the clock. So yeah, something that just didn't allow you to be who you are, your higher self. Okay, so let's clarify the Lovers in the reverse. clarify the lovers in the reverse. Clarify the lovers in the reverse. I'm going to take the first card that came out. And we have the Page of Wands. So yeah, Scorpio. Clarify the lovers in the reverse with the Page of Wands and the Upright. So yeah, this was a situation that you became, I would say, accustomed to the drama. You know, you became accustomed to it. And there may have been even more drama that added on. It took away from you. It didn't allow you to be your true self, even though you fought through that. But you became adjusted to it. You became adjusted to a uncomfortable or unhealthy situation. I kept hearing uncomfortable, okay? It was a situation that you knew wasn't right, but maybe because of the history that you had with this person or the love you had for this person, you stuck it out. You took the good with the bad, right? So, and the thing is about that, it gave you some sort of Five of Cups fulfillment, you know? It gave you fulfillment, even though you kind of looked a bit not as happy, not as cheerful, but it gave you some kind of fulfillment. And like I said, it could have been because you were used to this person. You could have been comfortable with this person and didn't want to think about being with anyone else, right? Sometimes that happens. A lot of times that happens. So where we are now, Scorpio, is the Queen of Pentacles in the reverse. You're not quite where you want to be, but you are working very hard to get there. You are just looking over. So, Seven of Swords, overall energy for this card. You're looking over things. You're looking over what happened, where you lost yourself, where you gained the clarity, the work that you've had to put in to heal. You could be still healing, but you're just looking at things from a different set of eyes. We have the Queen of Pentacles in the reverse. You could have been dealing with the fellow Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. Earth sign energy. You're just more aware. You want to get back to getting your pentacles or to get what you deserve. You want to get back there. So we're going to clarify the Queen of Pentacles in the reverse. Here we go. Yes. The World card. And the Hierophant. Yeah. So, Scorpio, you are just at a place where you had to come out of a tower. Had to come out of something that ended that meant a lot to you. But you had to come out of that for a reason. Right? You had to come out of that situation. So, you're no longer in it anymore. And I clarified the Queen of Pentacles in the reverse. I got the World card. You're looking over things. You're seeing new heights. You're seeing yourself with new love. You may be dating. You could be have your sights set on someone new. You know, you see yourself being your higher self, or you could have just more love for self, okay? Which is going to attract the love that you deserve. And then the Hierophant came out. So you could be getting some good advice from family and friends. You could have been watching other tarot readings for guidance. You could have been doing self-help, self-care. Anything that provided you reading the Bible, anything that provided you with some kind of fulfillment and understanding, this is what you did, Scorpio, to help with your healing, okay? And it's really helped you. So keep doing that so you can attract the love that you deserve. All right? So we're going to pull an oracle card for you, Scorpio. I'm hearing two shuffles. Oracle card for ordinary. So maybe you felt ordinary, or you're back to your ordinary ways. That was weird. Okay, oracle card for Scorpio. Yes, Scorpio, you are feeling like you are taking a fantastic voyage. I'm hearing fantastic voyage. There was a song back in the 90s by Coolio, Fantastic Voyage, and in that song he talks about a fantastic adventure, a fantastic time, probably with friends and family. And it's, this is how you're feeling. You're feeling like looking forward. You're feeling like applying flexibility in order to get to something better, right? Get to what's going to be your fulfillment, because you've had a very difficult situation. And the situation that you're in now could be fulfilling. It could now feel like you are on an abundant voyage, right? Peaceful, carefree. Doesn't mean it's without problems, but it's more positive, and you're going in with a different set of eyes and more experience. So yeah, this is where you are, Scorpio, looking good. All right? Keep up the good work. You're coming out of this unfocused energy in the reverse. You're no longer there, because guess what? You are heading towards your fulfillment. Okay? Thank you so much, Scorpio. I hope you have a blessed and safe week, or whenever you see this. Please comment in the comment section below. Like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you, and as always, take care, be blessed. Bye.